Emmy Award winner Leeza Gibbons graduated in 1975 from Irmo High School in Lexington, Richland, District 5, and in 1978 from the University of South Carolina. After getting her start at WSPA in Spartanburg, she later became a correspondent and co-host of Entertainment Tonight for 16 years. She then hosted her own syndicated daytime talk show, Leeza. In 2013, she won a Daytime Emmy for Outstanding Host in a Lifestyle Travel Program for her work on My Generation, a weekly lifestyle series produced by AARP. Miss Gibbons has taken her experiences hosting, producing, and writing to become an instrumental advocate for healthcare, wellness, and caregiving. After winning Celebrity Apprentice in 2015, she invested her earnings to support family caregivers at her flagship Leeza's Care Connection location in Columbia. Her focus on helping others call on their courage and summon their strength during a healthcare challenge is a common theme to her life. Her books, including New York Times bestseller Take Two, Your Guide to Creating Happy Endings and New Beginnings, and Fierce Optimism, Seven Secrets for Playing Nice and Winning Big, highlight Miss Gibbons' ability to provide practical inspiration and encouragement to anyone who believes they can create a successful life of happiness and purpose without selling out or giving in. In addition to an Emmy and New York Times bestseller, Leeza has received numerous recognitions for her achievements, including a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame and the Electric Retailing Association's Icon Award for her work selling over $1 billion in products through direct response.
Miss Leeza Gibbons.
This is so lovely and such a beautiful night for our family. So thank you very much to the organizers of this event, and thank you for the great work of this foundation, which is so important. For me, this is an opportunity to love up on you, Daddy, a little bit more. And how spectacular was my dad in his acceptance speech? I mean, really? Really? It's phenomenal. I always thought that my dad was just the smartest, coolest, most articulate, most passionate, best dressed, most handsome, never say die advocate that public education ever had. There's no stopping because I'm a chip off the old block. Sorry about that. And he is all of those things and so much more. So the opportunity to respect him and honor his work along with the spectacular inductees that he shares this inaugural class of the Hall of Fame with is really a lifetime opportunity, Pops. And all of us who are graduates and products of public education owe so much to the men, like the inductees tonight, and women who came before us and upon whose shoulders we stand. We just owe such a debt of gratitude for all that they did to pioneer excellence in education. Pops, you know, I think the world of you, and I think that you absolutely hung the moon. And along with Tom Ackerman, I have so many great memories of dinnertime conversations about education. My dad not only worked with Mr. Ackerman, they were dear friends, and his wife was my mother's best friend. And one of my best friends was Tom Ackerman's daughter, Becky, that accepted for him tonight. So that was a wonderful association. I was so proud for his honor tonight. And Dr. Bill Royster is a name loved and appreciated and respected by all who care about education in our state. So what wonderful company my dad is in means an awful lot to me. You know, my dad always knew that education was more than the collective number of hours that someone spends in a classroom. He always knew that it was about preparing students for what they needed to know about equality and about activism and about advocacy and about leadership and about being a part of the solution rather than whining about the problem. And so he modeled that. When I was in school, my dad thought that my skirts were too short. They were. And that I watched too much Dark Shadows after cheerleading practice, and I did. And I'm not certain when Dad saw me playing reporter Barbie with my Barbie dolls that I would ever really be a reporter and make it in the broadcast business, but I did. My dad has always encouraged me and always been proud of me, but I know never more proud than tonight because of the company that I am with, these amazing inductees, these distinguished graduates, and these alumni. Your brother was a star from the get-go, was a stellar standout in high school and then the Naval Academy and then NASA and beyond. I mean, a life of just one achievement after another. And Dr. Carrie Mullins came from Dreher High School, right? I think that everyone's intimidated when they meet Carrie because, I mean, how many people do you know who have the prize, the Nobel Prize in physics? Like, that's it. And kind of understanding that, oh yeah, for a technique that's widely heralded as one of the most significant of the 20th century, you know, I just want us all to go home and feel very insignificant tonight. It's a lot of company. So I left South Carolina to pursue my dreams, which took me to Texas and New York and California, but this is where I grew my values. And this is where I learned to succeed or fail in the classroom and on the field, and where I learned to strengthen my strength and to accommodate my weaknesses, which is really important. And this is where I participated in things that I wasn't so good at because it was the right thing to do and it was good for me, and not because you got a participation trophy. You're welcome. It was the right thing to do. This is where I learned to raise my hand and raise my voice, but not to talk back. It was a very special experience growing up here. So tonight, when we look at these outstanding honorees and what they have accomplished, I am so grateful for my time in School District 5. I never had the experience that students have today. I never sat alone at lunch by myself because mean girls were cyberbullying me on social media. I never had to worry that a gunman was going to break into my classroom and that I might not get home at the end of school that day. A lot to be said for the old days, right? But more still to be said for the environment in these days in which student leaders and administrators and teachers and mentors are emerging in this environment to change it just as the Hall of Fame inductees changed it for us. Thank you so much to my friends and my family and my husband, Stephen, who is the greatest life partner a girl could ever imagine. It took me a while to finally get it right. Boy, did I win. And I accept this on behalf of all of the people who inspired me and who guided me at School District 5, the people who put up with my stuff and called me out on it, and the people who instilled in me a fear of never wanting to disappoint them, because you certainly never disappointed me, especially you. Thank you so much.